So since we've entered a new year for our Buddy to Buddy report this month, we thought we'd take a look at the status of breast cancer in the United States. This is all according to the American Cancer Society. So we'll start with some basic statistics. About 1 in 8 women in the U.S., or 12%, will develop invasive breast cancer over the course of her lifetime. Breast cancer is the second most commonly diagnosed cancer among American women after skin cancer, and it is the second most deadly cancer after lung cancer. All right, let's talk about risk factors. The most significant risk factors for breast cancer are sex, being a woman, and age, growing older. Up to 10% of breast cancers can be linked to known genetic mutations. Those are things you can't control. Among the risk factors you can control are alcohol consumption, obesity, and the use of hormone replacement therapy after menopause. Next, you might be wondering, with all the attention focused on breast cancer in recent years, are we making any progress? Well, the number of diagnosed cases has actually been increasing by about 0.3% each year since 2004. One theory is that increasing obesity rates and decreasing fertility rates are driving that. However, when it comes to mortality, between 2013 and 2017, which is the last period we have statistics for, the overall death rate from breast cancer decreased by 1.3% per year. So a nice steady decline there. These decreases are thought to be the result of treatment advances and earlier detection through screening. And here are 3 positive developments to watch when it comes to prevention and treatment of breast cancer. First, in the last year, the FDA has approved 4 new drugs to treat HER2-positive breast cancers, which account for about 20% of all breast cancers. Second, there's a new therapy for triple-negative metastatic breast cancer. And third, just last month, the FDA approved a triple-negative breast cancer vaccine for use in human clinical trials. Now, while it could be years still before that actually makes it to market, researchers say the technology used to develop the vaccine could be applicable to other types of cancer as well. And that's this month's Buddy to Buddy report.